Hi, my dear student. Today we discuss quantum free electron theory and expression for electrical conductivity of metals. The quantum free electron theory was developed by Sommerfeld in 1924. Before going to this concept, I would discuss about drawbacks of classical free electron theory. The classical free electron theory was developed by Drude and Lorentz in 1900. According to them, every metal filled with a gas of electrons, just like molecules of gas. When absence of external field, all free electrons are move in a random motion. Some electrons move in one direction, some electrons move in another directions. Therefore, the net velocity is zero, as well as the current also zero. And this theory failed to explain some important physical concepts, such as specific heat of metal and a large value of mean free path. According to quantum theory, they did not possess same energy values. They can take some discrete energy values and distribute among different energy states, from lower energy state to higher energy state. The higher energy state is known as Fermi energy state. This is acts as one of the boundary between filled state and empty state. This concept can be explained with the help of this diagram. This diagram represents Fermi sphere. Inside of the sphere, each and every point represents free electron. Each and every free electron moves in a random motion with same velocity with all directions. When absence of external field, all free electrons are moving in a random motion. Therefore, the net velocity is zero, net current also zero. Now going to second diagram, this is represented a shifted sphere. When an external field E is applied to the Fermi sphere along x direction, the total Fermi sphere is shifted from A to B. This is opposite to the field direction. So according to quantum free electron theory, momentum of electron P equals to mv is equals to h cross k. Here h cross equals to h by 2 pi, k equals to 2 pi by lambda. Since these two values, h by 2 pi into 2 pi by lambda, then h by lambda equals to mb. Therefore, p equals to mb equals to h cross k. This is equation 1. From this equation, v equals to h cross k by m. This is differentiating with respect to t. Then dv by dt equals to h cross by m into dk by dt. In this equation, this is known as rate of change of velocity. Therefore, rate of change of velocity dv by dt equals to a. This is equals to ee by m. Then ee by m equals to h cross by m into dk by dt. Then simplify, we get dk equals to ee by h cross into dt. Then dk by dt equals to ee by h cross into dt. Then this is equation 2. Equation 2, integrating equation 2 and limit from 0 to t. Then 0 to t dk equals to 0 to t ee by h cross into dt. Kt minus k0 equals to delta k is equals to ee by h cross into tau, because of t is equals to tau. A tau is nothing but this is mean collision time, the mean time spent between two successive collision. Therefore, it can be written as tau. Therefore, delta k equals to ee by h cross into t. From relation between k and v, v can be written as v equals to h cross k by m. Therefore, delta v equals to h cross by m into delta k. You know delta k value. This value substituting this equation, then delta v is equal to h cross by m into ee by h cross into tau. Then simplify, delta v equals to ee by m into tau, or v equals to e tau by m into e. From this equation, delta v is known as average velocity. With the help of average velocity, calculate current density in terms of average velocity. Therefore, current density j equals to n into e delta v. Then j equals to n into e, substitute delta v value, that is average velocity, e tau by m into e. J equals to n e square tau by m into e. According to Ohm's law, j equals to sigma into e. Therefore, sigma e equals to n e square tau by m into e. Simplify, sigma equals to n e square tau by m. This is called electrical conductivity of electrons.